Hello, welcome to my channel, Great John Oyun, and today I want to talk about this sprouting. Now, sometimes it happens when the stem is too short, but also the roots are way too small for water propagation. There's barely any roots. If you put this on soil, they can never reach the bottom of the soil for water, and that's why you can see that the leaves are way too dry. The only way to save this is to water emergency propagation. Now this stem sprouting is long enough to put in a small glass jar, and also the roots are long enough to reach the water. Most of the people will do either this or the other way with plastic wrapping on top to prevent it from falling. So what they do is place the wrapping on top of the hole, poke a small hole in it so that this stem will put inside the hole to stay sturdy. I like this way because it's less waste, but the downside is it will easily fall off. But if I put it like this, it will stand sturdy. Everyone has their own method, so find a way that is suitable for you. Now what I want to talk about is how to make this cardboard to make a stand for this small sprouting with barely any roots and this plastic casing from a plastic jar cookie case. With this cardboard I want to show you how to make a stand for your small sprouting that has barely any roots. And the stem is also very short, so to do water propagation, make sure that the stem stays dry, because if it stays too wet all the time, you may get stem rot. So cut the piece cardboard to the size you want, depending on how big your sprouting is. Because my sprouting is very small in height, you cut the cardboard also small in width. Cut multiple pieces off the same width. The reason for that is because when it gets wet, it will expand and loosen. So I will show you why I did this. Now you have one round cardboard, two. Now you put the second cardboard, fold it like this, and put it inside the other one. You have another one, just put it inside the other one. Now you have some kind of shape that will stay in shape because you have the outer layer intact, but that will hold together the inner cardboard. Because my sprouting is very small, I need to put another cardboard inside this small hole shape. You could either hold it up, make it very small, and now put it inside this kind of big hole. Sometimes a bit difficult. And now you see there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 holes. Each are different sizes, depending on how big your sprouting is, of course. And now the easiest way to take this sprouting is just to make sure that this cardboard is in your hand. If you have a tweezer, use that to grab the sprouting at the side stem very carefully. Make sure to take off any soil. just put it inside the hole that's left. And now you see that it holds together. And place this cardboard inside the plastic casing you got from a cookie package. Place it very carefully. And now you see it's standing. What you now need to do is water it, but because cardboard expands when it absorbs water, it's best to spray at the sides. Here we have a water bottle sprayer. Set it on fine spraying. Spray it on the sides. Do it on each side. Until you see that the bottom is with water, not too much. I use cardboard because it absorbs water and it prevents that the water at the bottom gets too much. The stem preferably has to stay dry, because if it gets too mushy, it will rot, of course. And the leaves must also stay dry. This way, it prevents any rotting at the bottom or too much water. And even if the cardboard absorbs the water and there's nothing left, the roots will suck up the water from the cardboard it needs. That way, it will prevent any dried water evaporation by the sun, and it will stay longer in the cardboard. It will suck out the water it needs when it needs. Of course, a cardboard dries by air, but it's a much slower rate when it's just like this. If you do like this, the water evaporates much faster by the sunlight. I hope you've learned something from it. Thanks for watching. Bye.